I play Margaret Ruskin, and this is my son John. And
we're in character.
We're in character. I'll do the talking.
Okay, sorry. Yeah. Still in character.
So, the Ruskins were great patrons of Turner. They bought an awful lot of his work. They were a very idiosyncratic family. Mrs. Ruskin, a fiercely religious woman, and brought up her son in really quite an extreme way, I think it's
absolutely
fair to say.
And the father was kind of opposite, really, wasn't he? He was quite relaxed. And that created...
Yes.
When you add those two people together, I think it creates quite a complicated human being, and that human being is John Ruskin.
Mm.
And he was pulled from both sides, I think, for most of his life. Mm. But he championed Turner's work. He was Turner's biggest champion, and he wrote a huge volume, 5 volumes of a thing called Modern Painters, which not only talks about Turner, but talks about painting full stop.
A hugely influential piece of work, that
absolutely.
Is, isn't
and
it?
He started
I mean, it was
school.
An extraordinary challenge, really, wasn't it, for you, actually, Josh, let's face it, to encompass the enormous intellect, really, that was.
No, it was a struggle for me to encompass the
struggle.
Enormous intellect.
Huge struggle.
No, it was. He was the one note, I think, Mike, the biggest note that Mike gave me and continued to give me was, why did you stop talking? Ruskin would never stop talking. So don't stop talking. So then I had to go and read some books, so I had something to talk about, which we did
before we
started.
We did,
yes. So that's where we fit in.
Tim brings great humanity, I think, to any role he plays. And this is no exception. It's an extraordinary performance that kind of explains... He doesn't use many words, but it kind of explains the man's heart. Well, for me, it does. Mm.
And that he was a person, as any artist is, a person, first and foremost. And their art is either an extension of them or a separate part of them. And I think, like you say, he didn't really have much to say, but everything he had to say was on the canvas. And he was such an interesting character in life anyway, that even without his genius as one of the world's greatest painters, there would still be a movie to make about him without that.
I've worked with Mike 3 times now, and whenever I've worked with Mike, I've always had some insight into an aspect of life or history that I wouldn't have had I not been working with Mike. So he's a very, very interesting, challenging person to work with. And I think that's there in the films.
Absolutely, yeah. I was saying earlier, if you have your own method that isn't Mike's method when you come to do a film of his, chuck it out the window, because it's Mike's way or the highway, and I think that's fair to say, isn't it? That's the only way Mike works, the only way Mike knows how to work, and produces the results that he gets.
What I think's great about the way of working is that it takes you back to life, and I think it's very important for actors from time to time to go back to life and not be constantly deriving their performances from other performances, if you see what I mean. And that's always a great, great part of working with Mike, is to be reminded that what we're actually here for is to reflect life, humanity.
Yeah.